Everything's gonna be alright. Don't you worry about a thing.
Hi gang, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Wednesday, February 9th, 2022. Back on February 3rd of this year, Elon Musk sent up a Starlink rocket. This is an image of the Falcon 9 rocket that had over 49 Starlink satellites. Many of you will probably remember the strange sightings that was seen from Ohio all the way through Arkansas, Mississippi, Illinois, that some people said was related to this rocket, which I don't believe. This here is an image of that object that was seen. Now, this was January 31st. This was sent to me, was seen in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. But 40 of the 49 satellites have either re-entered Earth's atmosphere or are going to re-enter. One of the re-entries was reported to the American Meteor Society. It was spotted from Mexico to Texas, and here's a Twitter post showing that re-entry. Here on AMS is 58 of those reports. Many people described it as a slow-moving meteorite. But more than likely, it was probably one of Elon Musk's Starlink satellites that had failed to reach orbit because of a solar storm, a solar flare that was impacting the Earth at the time of launch. Here we have an image of a solar storm that probably affected those satellites. It erupted around the 30th of February, the 31st, depending on what time zone you were in. And yeah, this bad boy is what created the drag on the satellite, so they couldn't reach orbit. Here on satview.org, they track space junk and satellites that are coming in, and I was really surprised that they have 6 more Starlink satellites. One will re-enter today, and the rest are going to re-enter on the 10th, the 11th, the 12th, the 13th, and the 14th. Now, according to satellite view here, the one for today has already re-entered. And it looks like re-entry point was up there by Japan. We got Australia here, Indonesia, etc. Here we have an image of the map of all the different Starlinks. There's evidently 22 that all fly together. And the drag on the satellite was 50% higher than what they had expected and what had happened in previous launches, SpaceX said in a statement. Starlink tried to fly the satellites in a safe mode to reduce the atmospheric drag, so I guess they knew it was coming. But they still were not able to reach their final destination. SpaceX also said in a statement that the affected satellites won't collide with other satellites as they deorbit. There won't be any orbital debris and no satellite parts will hit the Earth, though more than likely burn up at re-entry. This is an image before they were launched. SpaceX has launched more than 2,000 Starlink satellites into orbit, out of which nearly 1,900 of them are still functioning. This has been the biggest loss for SpaceX so far, and luckily, they have not had a single rocket failure, which could easily take out a whole batch of satellites at once. More than likely, they're going to take it a little bit more serious when there is a solar event going on. We all learn from our mistakes, and hopefully them there at Starlink, yeah, they learned a little bit more about what could happen with these CMEs that come off the sun. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.